That was kind of the point. We do understand that perhaps the biggest questions many of you have around your investments in Microsoft do come around where goeth the Windows PC business, what's happening, what'll happen with new form factors, what are the competitive dynamics, and we thought it was a great opportunity for us to share that fully and then do this meeting right after so you'd have kind of that, if you will, with you will, fresh in our minds. Certainly, the release of the developer preview of Windows 8 is just that. It's a developer preview. We've got a lot of work to do between here and there, but at least we get a chance to get some early sense of kind of how people react, what do they think about the path that we've taken. It was gratifying, 9:30 this morning, somebody came and grabbed me before I went on stage to tell me we'd had our 500,000th download. And we are seeing, at least from people who are playing and looking very early, we're seeing some positive reaction, and I think that's extremely important. We think we've got it right. We think the formula that says you bring the best of the tablets and the best of the PC together, that you embrace the cloud, you embrace emerging HTML standards is exactly right. But if you look at some of the quotes that we've seen in the Twitter feeds and in the blogosphere, and I went through most of these over the course of my discussion this morning, but the initial reaction has been all we would have hoped for in terms of being positive, both on Windows 8 and, frankly, probably even more positive than we might have expected on Windows 8 Server, which has been quite remarkable. The importance of Azure and Windows 8 Server for private cloud is important. If you were parsing through those numbers as they flip through quickly, our server and tools business, our Windows business, and our Office business are all over $15 billion in revenue and all extremely important to the long-term health and success of the company. And so seeing the response both to our public and private cloud work, as well as the work we're doing on the client, is extremely important. We wanted to give you an opportunity during the course of the day, as Bill said, to hear about Windows at the conference, have a chance to hear a little bit more in depth about the cloud, because this transition to the cloud is still very early, both for the server and Azure platform, as well as for Office. And yet it probably has the most profound effect over time in how we think about our revenue and pricing models, and we want to spend a little bit more time with you on that, give you an update on what's going on with Bing. That's a very important investment. It's an investment that's not only important as it relates to kind of the opportunity in search, which we remain very excited about, but it's a fundamental set of core technologies that we think we absolutely need to invest in broadly to be in the devices business, to be in the cloud device software business, the cloud platform business, et cetera. I want to take a few minutes, ground a couple things in our overall worldview, maybe give you just a little bit of an update on some of the things we haven't talked about, and then we'll open up for a broader Q&A. The first thing which I hope is obvious about our point of view is Windows is at the center. Certainly, I can read plenty of places where people will question whether that's a good idea or not. I think it's an exceptionally good idea. And if you took nothing else out of build, you certainly should have taken that Windows is front and center in our strategy. As Steven Sinofsky said about Windows 8 on the client, we have to reimagine Windows. We have to change Windows. But there's absolutely no reason not to build on the incredible technology strength, the incredible base of applications and skills, the incredible brand strength in Windows. And whether it's reimagining the client for tablets as well as PCs, the work that we talked about at Build with Windows 8, whether it's the work that Satya had a chance to talk about revamping for both private and public cloud, for this world of virtualization and big data and very mass scale online operations. Windows Phone, and I'm going to take a chance to to just remind you and give you a couple updates. I did this over at the conference, but I want to underscore a couple of additional points. Windows is at the center of our go-forward strategy, and we feel very comfortable that that's a smart thing to do for our customers and a smart thing to do for our shareholders. And certainly as people have a chance to experience both Windows Server 8 and Windows 8, I think that'll certainly be borne out. If you put that together and say, okay, what's different? What are the interesting things in our worldview sitting as Microsoft and saying, how do we go to market? How do we compete? How do we see the world differently maybe than some of the other folks that we get a chance to compete with every day? I'd say there's probably six things I'll highlight. First is this notion of Windows centricity. Second, and certainly I think probably maybe a little bit different perspective from us, this notion that says we have to embrace and drive new hardware form factors is very much on our mind. We have a great ecosystem of partners in the phone world, in the server world, in the data center world, and in the PC world. And yet one of the things that certainly we are focused in on is morphing the dialogue so that we and our partners are getting in front of new hardware trends together. And I think that's more important now than perhaps at any other time in our existence. Natural interface, voice, gestures, touch, the kinds of things that we showed off with Kinect that has been certainly very well received, that's just really a surface that's only begun to be scratched. Chi talked in his remarks about user intent. The most natural thing to do isn't just to touch, see, feel, but to say what you want to achieve, what's your task, what are you trying to accomplish, and have these intelligent devices be able to do something coherent with that. So the investments that we're making, whether it's in vision or speech or touch or pen or in the core intent engine that Chi talked about, really are fundamental, not just for each of the individual businesses, but for a fundamental transformation we think will happen over the course of the next several years. We're bet on the cloud. You'd say, okay, well, how unique does that make it? Well, it makes us very unique versus about half of our enterprise customers, and it doesn't make us very unique at all versus the other half. Yet the truth is, if you take a look at everybody who's focused in on the enterprise, people tend to come at the problem as it's all about the cloud, or really it's all about on-premise or some hosted form. I think we are unique, whether it's with Office, with the work that we're doing with Dynamics, the work Satya talked to you about in Server and Azure. We're unique in trying to synthesize a coherent private cloud, public cloud view. Enterprise and consumer. I do get asked frequently enough, why do you do both? And I will tell you that I think it is essential for our success and for our differentiation that we do both. Anything that the end user participates in, it is important, essential to pioneer in the consumer market, and yet one-third of personal computers today are sold essentially to enterprises as a proxy. At the same time, the technologies that are getting proven today at massive scale in the consumer internet are the same technologies that need to be put in a production form for the enterprise customer. And that, to me, remains one of the core strengths of Microsoft versus the other guys that we see in the market. And last but certainly not least, in addition to building core platforms for cloud, for server, for end-user devices, we're going to continue to invest in applications. Office, Dynamics, Halo. We had a chance to give you a little video clip of that at the beginning. Because I think investing in our own first-party applications is essential both to establishing platforms, proving them out technologically, and giving us opportunities to profit financially from the success of those platforms. So these form some of the core elements, I would say, that guide us as we approach this set of businesses in which we are invested. I would say it's not all that. We may be a little bit sort of broader than most companies in our industry, And yet we really only have seven things that we're working on. Phones, PCs, and TVs, the software for those. PCs broadly, of course, including tablets and slates. A back-end infrastructure platform with Windows Server and Windows Azure. Productivity and communications. Information and search. And ERP and CRM. That's what we do. That's what we're about financially. Some additional scenarios get built out in the course. Zoom has been important for us to build out in order to power some of our devices and provide music and video services. But there is such a rich opportunity in just these seven areas to innovate, to invest in new scenarios, to take advantage of the cloud to do things that people are not expecting, to transform the definition of these devices. I think this is a broad set, an interesting set, and frankly a set of opportunities that has a lot. Peter Klein had a chance to try to dimensionalize it. But if you ask me, there's plenty of shareholder value growth from investing in additional success, successfully investing in additional success in these categories. We had a chance at the Build conference to talk about Windows. We'll talk a little bit more here about Windows Phone and Xbox. You had a chance to hear from Satya and Chi about Bing and Windows Server. And I'm going to have a chance to talk to you a little bit in detail about Office. I do want to highlight, though, before I move on, our Dynamics business. Our Dynamics business, we started off down the path of ERP and CRM software about 10 years ago with the acquisition of Great Plains. I would say it took us a while to get our mojo running and working. Over the last several years, that has really emerged as a business that produces hundreds of millions of dollars of profit annually and grows at a pretty reasonable clip, just as a piece of our overall business solutions business. We're certainly putting the pedal to the metal. If you look at our launch recently of Dynamics AX, the work we're doing with CRM in the cloud, and some of the sort of competitive pressure that we're putting on Salesforce and Oracle and others, I think it too is a good opportunity and perhaps one that we don't speak about often enough. Let me talk a little bit about Windows Phone. It was under a year ago that we launched the first Windows phones. Maybe not all that sort of stunning a thing to the folks in this room, but it's really hard for me to even think back about the days before the Windows phone. We haven't sold quite as many, probably, as I would have hoped we would have sold in the first year, and yet I think the product that we put into the market, the positive reception from the people who've bought them, the enthusiasm we see from the hardware vendor community at this stage, particularly with some of the dynamics that have gone on in the last year, Google buying Motorola, our partnership with Nokia, some of the intellectual property issues. We see more enthusiasm. We've turned around a fantastic second release in about a year. We've got a clear roadmap that we're executing on to try to bring additional innovations like IE9, First, DirectX to the Windows Phone platform. And I'm just I'm not saying I love where we are, but I'm very optimistic on where I think we can be. I think with a little bit more effort, a little bit more energy, the level of enthusiasm from the customer base is high enough. We just got to kick this thing to the next level. And I think we're in absolute good shape in order to be a very strong third ecosystem in the smartphone world. Nokia will launch their first phones. That's really important. Some people say, is it really? Why? What? With Nokia, we have a dedicated hardware partner who's all in on Windows phones. They're working with us in exactly the way we describe to try to get into new markets, find new price points, take a look at new hardware designs. They're all in on Windows. They're not doing something with Android or blah, 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 blah. Boom! Our innovation interests are completely aligned. And I think that that is very important and, in a sense, has been very well received from the silicon vendors on up to and including some of the other guys who are in the handset business. Certainly, as I had a chance to say this morning, a lot of the market reaction and a lot of the reviews have been great, but there's just more for us to do as we move forward to establish Windows Phone in the market. Office is the biggest business that didn't have its own breakout. That was really done in the interest of time so that we could get you through the morning session today at Build, get over here, and still get you out at a reasonable hour. But Office is our biggest business. Office is growing rapidly, as you saw in some of the numbers that Peter and Kevin showed you. The launch of Office 365 in June is a big, big deal for us. It's a big deal competitively. It's a big deal in terms of giving us opportunity to reach new customers and grow overall revenue and gross margin. It's a big opportunity to speed up and increase the agility and speed with which we're able to bring certain new innovations to market. And I think represents one of the biggest kind of, let me say, quiet opportunities in the Microsoft portfolio. I get asked, when are you going to crack through in China? And cloud's probably an important part of that. Hard to answer that question, but the cloud would be an important part of that. How do we reach more small businesses and really help them come online and automate? Office 365 is part of that. How do we move into new scenarios, whether it's note-taking or real-time communication, voice and video? Office 365 is an important part of that. Kevin mentioned our Link product. Link is, if you will, probably the hottest thing we've got going with enterprises right now. You do a Link demo, as Kevin said, people really resonate. People want some of the advantages that Skype brings, but with more professional context, more notion of meetings and how they get done in the business world than perhaps Skype would offer. And so we've driven forward. I'll talk about Skype because it's an important complement. And some of the most important reasons to move forward with that acquisition are to be able to let our customer base across their work and personal personas to better communicate.